Today's lesson on geometric proofs. In this lesson, we will discuss how to create a proof and how to properly use statements and reasons in order to make sure that we prove the statement that we're aiming to look at. Now, a proof is a validation of a statement beyond any doubt, given that the assumptions used in that proof are generally agreed upon. We can use axioms, theorems, and postulates within our proof in order to back up the statements that are being made. One particular type of proof is a proof by contradiction, which uses the fact that to prove one or two contradictory statements true is enough to prove another one is false. Now, this is just one of many of the types of proofs and methods that we use to prove statements true. When making proofs, it's important to follow certain rules and procedures. For one, when doing constructions in a proof, we have to make sure that the only instruments we use are a compass and a straight edge. Every statement we make must be given a strong reason, and those reasons must be limited to facts, definitions, and, as mentioned before, postulates, axioms, and theorems. Now, with a proof, you generally get a given statement associated with the diagram, and that most of our statements and reasons are organized in a nice two-column fashion where you can associate each unique reason to a unique statement. Now, let's take a look at our very first proof and see how we can fill it out. As you can see, we have a diagram with given information. I'm given that DAF is equal to angle B and that FAC is equal to angle C. And I need to prove that DAC is equal to B plus C. Now, the first two statements in my proof are both given, so I will write given as such. DAF is equal to B and FAC is equal to C. That was given to me in the above section. Now, the next statement says that DAF plus FAC is equal to B plus C. If I were to look at both of those in the diagram and where they are, I know that adding up two parts of any whole will be equal to the whole, which, as we can recall, was axiom 2. So I can say axiom 2 within our geometry would be a good enough reason. My next statement, DAF plus FAC is equal to DAC, with two parts out of that angle, I can then kind of switch gears and use the angle addition postulate instead, since both parts of those angles will definitely equal the whole thing. Now, to say that DAC is equal to B plus C, my remaining statement would simply be to substitute out certain things that I know are equal. So I subsequently can use the substitution property of equality. Now let's take a look at another type of proof. In completing this column proof, I am told that AEFB is a straight line and that AF is equal to EB. So to say that AFEB is a straight line with my first statement, the reason would be given. With my second statement, AF is equal to EB, again, another given statement. Now, looking at my third statement, it seems that from AF and EB, from both of those, I am subtracting EF. Now, since I am subtracting the same thing from two things that are both equal, I can denote that, and again, use axiom 2 because I'm subtracting an equal quantity from two quantities that are already equal. And because this is axiom, with my last statement saying AE is equal to FB, the differences of those two would end up giving me equal quantities. And I could say this, that is AE is equal to FB, by using the subtraction property of equality.